Okay, when did almond milk become so bloody popular?
When we found their nipples.
At 20 points, if you can tell me the country where snowboarding was invented.
Oh, well, it's going to be some wacky shit, because that's this show just loves... Oh, here's the obvious answer. Blah, blah. You're an idiot, Nick. So I'll say Egypt.
My mum says they used to give us... used to feed us whiskey and brandy to shut us up when we were younger.
Oh, that worked.
Describe a really dangerous trumpet, please.
Nish's bum bum.
I can't believe I'm about to tell this story.
Okay. I'm going to settle back.
Once, when I was at home with my parents, we were all sat in the kitchen and I had to break wind. And I did it and it was silent and I was like, fantastic. And then my dad got the yellow pages out and I was like, why are you getting the yellow pages out? And he's like, I think we need a plumber, the pipes burst.
Last time I was in Yorkshire, I cried. I was so happy.
Are you sure it wasn't the peri-peri minute?
Why were you so happy?
Because, you know the way people are really nice and you're suddenly overwhelmed? I've been menopausal for a while.
Why were the Middle Ages such a trying time for animals?
Well, as Susan just said, the Middle Ages are a hard time for anybody.
That's so true.
Susan's gonna cry. I'm sorry, I take it back.
And if the plants don't get you at Annick, then some of the bugs might as well. So blister beetles, for example, there's a little blister beetle. You can find them by the shore here in Essex and Devon and so on. And they have a defensive secretion, and that was used as an aphrodisiac since ancient times, but also toxic in tiny concentrations. It's actually known as Spanish fly. It probably gets its reputation for being an aphrodisiac because it irritates your urethra when you pee, and that draws blood into the area and causes an erection just before you go.
So you would literally die hard.
That's a whole other script.
I know. Quick supplementary question. Why might it be good to go on a ride with a lot of jerks? Ooh.
Is it because the pointed bit of the seat goes up your butt and that feels nice?
I'm going to go with that's a personal fantasy, Nish. Imagine the wall is here, OK? Do you hang it?
You've got to hang it this way.
What, why? Why have you got to hang it that way?
Just because, like, otherwise you're a godless prick.
Some poor sod when it first happened. God, cup of tea, please, in 1183.
Yeah.
What sort of milk do you want? Oh, I don't know. Well, do you want coconut milk, sheep milk, ewe milk, iguana milk, llama milk? Milk expressed by Sandra, who sits in the back office squirting it in. Full fat in the morning, semi-skimmed in the afternoon.
Oh. Gosh, there wasn't much diversity then, was there?
No. No, there was. It's not wild on diversity. They all were...
As have found love. I'm always hungry after a blowjob.
Yeah. How dare you?
Yeah. There's cyanide in apple pips.
Yeah, that, the poison garden woman. This was part of a... She said, look at that, look at that. Apples, they look innocent enough, don't you? But there's just a few pips and that could absolutely wipe someone out. How many pips do you think would need to give someone enough cyanide to kill them? And a woman put up her hand and went, I reckon that's 50. And she said, you know, you're absolutely right. How did you know that? And she said, well, I trade 49 on me husband and it didn't quite work.
And in fact, archaeologists have discovered 2,000-year-old poo sticks in the latrine pit of an old rest stop on the Silk Road.
The archaeologists have got that wrong, I wager.
Do you think?
What they've found is a ship hole with some sticks in.
But we know it was sticks because they're wrapped with cloth and they've got the eggs of parasites.
Oh, it's a shit stick. That's different. Yes.
As we can see, there will be snowstorms over this village. And in Batman, there will be lovely weather.
OK, brilliant. And they use 8 muscles hooked up to a computer to detect toxic pollution in the water supply. It's a type of biomonitoring. It's like... I guess it's like a modern version of the canary in the coal mine.
Right. Yeah.
So mussels are filter feeders, right? They let water pass through their open mouths and then filter out, you know, the plankton and the tiny plants that they want to eat. Each one of the mussels in Warsaw has a coil...
Well, you're a mussel.
A mussel.
Yeah, a mussel like that.
Oh,
To be honest, it took me a while. I thought you meant a muscle mussel.
No. Yes. Oh,
mussel! Sandy, you have got your thickest panel ever. That is saying something.
Honestly, like being present at the birth of speech. It's an ocean creature, okay? I'd have been better off with 3 clams going.
Alan could oil himself up and send me a photograph.
What is happening? And you're so young. Right, you've got a little tiny speaker beside you. Please can
That's
you
a very rude way to refer to Susan, isn't it? Do you know what? Do you know what? I'm just so hurt that you haven't... I've been working out.
Yeah.
You know when you're at school and you ignore the person you fancy the most?
Oh.
Have you thought maybe that might be what's happening?
Oh! Oh.
This is the most erotic QR.
I think, well, what would you do to me if you saw me in the morning? You know, when I feed on me and stuff and I've got biscuit in my bra, what would you do?
Say biscuit in your bra again.
Sometimes if you eat shortbread on trains and you get home and at night when you take your bra off, there's just special biscuit that falls out.
My glasses are steaming up.
So, a little bit like Clark Kent, I'm going to put them on. OK, here is the trick. As soon as I put them on, who do you think I look like now?
Prue Leith is the right answer.
It's somebody badass. It's a person who has killed more baddies on screen than any other actor.
Oh.
I'm going John Wayne.
It's Mila Jovovich.
Oh.
Look, do you not think?
Really?
Uncanny.
Uncanny.
What's going on here? What's going on?
Yeah. Okay, do you know who she is?
She's not even wearing glasses, you know that, right?
No, so...
Have you ever been chloroformed?
That's your gift from this show, isn't it?
Have you been chloroformed?
No.
So what brought on that question?
They used to do it a lot in shows, didn't they?
What?
That hanky.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I think it's not in the script so much because people don't have hankies anymore.
No, it's the hanky that's the problem. Yeah. The chloroform.
I've got the chloroform. Now how am I going to apply it?
Yes.
Chin roll. Don't be absurd. When I was a kid, every old person had a hanky up their sleeve. Yeah. You never see it these days.
I always have a hanky.
I always have a hanky.
Yeah, I shouldn't have said it.
Yeah. And so, for example, Kim Jong-un, the North Korean leader, he takes his own toilet everywhere with him. That's not him burying
not
it.
Burying okay.
That's really clear. How many tonsils do you have?
Oh. Up in the morning.
How many tonsils I have?
Yeah.
Half.
What?
Had my tonsils out.
Yeah.
When I was 21.
Mm-hmm.
One of them grew back. Just a little bit.
We couldn't have a German chocolate cake on the show in case one person in the audience had a nut allergy.
Oh, really? I always thought a nut allergy was a very good euphemism for lesbian. What's Sandy like? Well, you know she's got a nut allergy.
Can I just say, as a hetero woman, you don't have to be a lesbian to have a nut allergy.
But you might want to stop your own snoring and train yourself not to snore.
Oh, I do. Well, I snore a little bit and my girlfriend's got these... She's got noise-cancelling fists.
I don't have any children, but I have seen children.
Oh, well, that'll do.